To this session on how to use test script recorder in JMeter. In this session we are going to see what is test script recorder and how do we use it to record test in JMeter. Towards the end of this session we will also look at some useful tips. So let us begin and let us see what is test script recorder in JMeter. Let us go to our JMeter and you can see there is this workbench here, and if you right click on the workbench and go to add and go to non-test elements, here you will see HTTPS test script recorder. So HTTPS test script recorder is a workbench element. You will not find it anywhere else, and it is used to record our user actions on browser. So now let us see how can we record our test using the test script recorder. Let us go back to our workbench and now we will do a right click on workbench, add non-test element and test script recorder. And we have got this window for test script recorder. Also, we will go to our test plan and add a thread group. And then we will add a logic controller. And we will add recording controller. So whatever we will record will get placed under the recording controller. Now let us go back to our test script recorder and let us understand. We have to give a port, so we will make our browser listen to this particular port. You can keep it 8888, which is default, or you can use any other port as well. For example, I am giving 8181, and then you can select any of these target controller. So you can keep it by default if you have already added a recording controller, because it will check if we have a recording controller and add all the samples there. And then you have the grouping preferences and other preferences. I'm keeping the other things as default. And in case you want to get a deeper knowledge about each and every of these options, you can go to this link. I will make this link available in the description of this video, and here you have all the information regarding this test script recorder. If you scroll down, you will get this section where each and every element is described. So here you can get all the information about this particular element and all the options it has. So let us go back to our JMeter, and now here we have to start recording, and before we start recording we have to make our browser listen to this particular port 8181. So I'm going to my Firefox, and here I will go to Firefox preferences. You can also go to options and tools, and here I will go to advanced and go to settings under network, and here I will say manual proxy configuration. I will say localhost and the port number that I have given in JMeter, which is 8181. Say OK, and now I will start the HTTP test script recorder and hit the start button. And you might get this message that a certificate is created in JMeter bin directory, and we have to add this certificate in our browser to enable our browser record our actions. So what this means is, if you go to your JMeter bin directory, you will find this certificate created by this particular name. So what we have to do is, we have to go to our browser, and again we have to go to the certificates. In case of Firefox, you have to go to Firefox preferences, and again you have to go to advanced, and here we have to go to certificates, view certificates, and here you have to import and select the certificate and import it, and then you have to check this certificate can identify websites and select OK. Now in case you are using any other browser or you need help in installing the certificate on your browser, again you can go to the same URL, and if you go down, here is all the description about the certificates. And in case you are using any other browser, you can go to this section, installing certificate in Firefox, then you have Chrome and Internet Explorer, and then Opera. So this is how we can make our browser ready to listen to all our requests, and now we can start recording our actions. So I will go to this website lifecharger.org, and you can see all these actions are getting recorded. So as soon as I will hit anything here, you can see these actions are getting recorded here. So I will click on this link and you can see this action is getting recorded. Wherever I will click, these actions are getting recorded here. And then once your recording is done, you can go back to your test script recorder and hit stop. Okay, now a couple of useful things. You can see it has recorded some other elements as well, which I do not require. All these samples, I just require the main samples, but it has recorded every other action as well. So what you can do is you can go back to your test script recorder, and here you have this section where we can provide our preferences for including and excluding content. So here you can say, if you go to this URL patterns to exclude, this is add suggested exclude. This will automatically add this regular expression, and it will make all these samples which are CSS, GIF and all these formats exclude and will not record into our samples. You can also hit dot star so that it does not record any of these. So let me just clear all these recording samples and then let me start again. And also you can add a listener to this test script recorder. I am selecting view results tree so that you can also see the results while you are recording. And also make sure that when you save your test plan, the workbench is not saved. So you will have to save it separately by going to right click and save selection as, in case you require it. Now let us start our script recorder again, and I will say start. Okay. And now let us see what all samples it will record. And you can see it is not recording the GIF now. So I will go to some other link. And you can see it is just recording the main samples. And now I will say stop. And now our recording is done. I can add a listener to my test plan, and I can run it to test all my recording is done successfully or not. So I'll go to my ThreadGroup. I will keep the number of users as 1 itself and just run it from here. I do not want to save it now. And let us see the results. And you can see everything is working fine. I can definitely change the names and give some meaningful names here. So our web test plan in JMeter is ready now. Let us look at some useful tips. So in our last session, we have already seen that we have some inbuilt templates in JMeter. So if you go to your JMeter, and if you are using JMeter with version 2.10 above, you can see there is this icon for templates. Also, you can go to File and Templates, and here you can see we have all these templates, and we have a recording, and recording with think time template. So let us select recording and say create. And you can see we have got all these necessary and basic components already created. You can go to the ThreadGroup, and we already have this recording controller. You can go to Workbench, and you can see all this test script recorder is already present, and it also has all these URL patterns to exclude. So now what we have to do is we just have to set up our browser with the proxy and start recording. So this will be very useful. You can start very fast and you can save a lot of time and effort. I hope test script recorder and its use is very clear to you now. In case you have any doubts or any question, do write them down in the comments and I will try to answer as soon as I can. Thanks for watching and keep learning.